Right, Andrew's told me to come up filming. It's been absolutely pouring with a... He's finished the greenhouse! How cool is that? Look. Oh, that's the wrong way. How lovely is that? And the smoke inside. Oh, a dog's bed. A homemade, just till we're ready, shelving. A luxury breakfast. How cool is my greenhouse? So he's put weed suppressant under and covered it in pea beach. Oh, I'm so pleased after the disaster of that polytunnel. I have got a second greenhouse. Oh, that is so exciting. We've done that, finished that off sneakily. Let's look from the outside once more. Up and running after the storm. We'll ignore all this bit. How cool is that? I love my hubby. Blaze, look, you got bed. Look, Blaze. Blaze, come on, look. Look. Come on. Blaze, look. Good boy. Good boy. Then you've got a bed in the new greenhouse and you can get nice and warm. Yeah, check it out. No, you've got a pig. What do you think, Blaze? Blaze, what do you think of the new greenhouse? Sit down, sit down, sit. That's your bed, so you can sit in the sun with me when I'm working. What do you think, Blaze? What do you think? Yeah. Oh, how excited am I? He's obviously come up this morning. We had a late light last night, so I had to lay in, and he's finished off this greenhouse. So I've bought some of my slightly hardier things off to go in here because I've only got a smaller heater here for this one so far. I am really, really excited. And Blaze, if I can show you, let's start it. And look at Blaze. Blaze. A bit in the greenhouse. Blaze, you've got a bit in the greenhouse. You want another bit of the secret breakfast, don't you? There you go. There we are. So I'm happy, so I can be pricking out in here with Blaze by my side, sunning himself. I've got some space back, and that polytunnel frame is going up the allotment, and that's going to be another project. I am going to show you how to prick out and pot up cosmos. Although these cosmos seem very reasonably spaced, what we've got to remember, they've been planted in John and Liz number one, and as seedlings now, they require more nutrients, so I'm going to pot them up into John and Liz number two. Right, these are candy stripe cosmos. So I've got some wet John Innes number two, made a hole in it, and I handle the seedling by its seed leaves. Don't touch the stem because we don't want to bruise and damage it, and gently, whoops, tease out the roots. Put them in the pot, to as deep as they were, and now they're ready to grow on in Johnniness number 2 with a little bit more nutrients. I'll show you that once again. Ready, damp, and Johnniness number 2. Hold them by their seed leaves, not their true leaves. This one, sometimes you might get this where you have to gently break away the root ball. There we go. And I will pop it in to the pot, firm it down. There we go. Right, today it's clearing the rest of the perennial weeds like we've done in some beds and rotivate the whole pot and reconfigure it. But we've got a lot of grass to cut off and we've got a lot of weeds still to dig. Well, this corner we've hand weeded to get rid of as many perennials before rotivating, and we're creating just a big compost heap up there for the time being. We're clearing this corner of all the weeds and are going to rotivate that. Harry's just come down for 5 minutes and he wants to look like he's working, because he's a man.
So we've been an actual worker.
Oh, you're an actual worker. And Andrew is coming round to the idea you do need to get the weeds out first. But he's been working really hard on the garden. He was the one that finished the greenhouse first thing this morning. I wonder when World Naked Gardening Day boys is. There's once a year. Do you fancy that? How do you fancy World Naked Gardening?
Not particularly.
Okay,
some sheep instead.
That sounds wrong. Andrew, World Naked Gardening?
Hide behind you.
Eh?
Hide behind you.
Hide behind me. I think you deserve a slap for that. Right. Okay, so as you can see, it's coming on. It's getting much more tidy. Let me do a wide shot for you. Very late in the day, I know, but because of my injury, I haven't been able to do anything. So, from this corner, it's ours now, up to the corner where we're putting everything at the moment, until we can sort things out here. So this is the length and breadth of the Lottie, and we're lucky because if you take a look with us, I don't know if you can see the downs in the very background and through to beautiful Wealden woodland. We're really lucky. Okay, so say bye guys.
Bye guys.
Lally. Okay, bye from Lally, bye from hubby, and bye from me.
Right, here he is, a rhododendron, lesson 1. make sure it lurches really fast forwards towards your raspberries and you nearly cut them up. Then drag it back with loads of soil behind you, make it really, really difficult. As you can see, it's really struggling there. Trying to pull forward again, get it right back before you can start again. That's it, let it lurch forward, ready to get your raspberries in for the second time.